27 and we are learning English today, literature. And the chapter we have today is a very interesting one and it is related to your SST also. So the name of your chapter is Fire, Friend and Foe. Fire, Friend and Foe. So it is a very interesting chapter and it is based not on a story but it is a general thing, the thing which is related to your social science, general knowledge, and of course your literature. How it is related to all three, I will tell you. First of all, fire. We are looking at the title Fire, Friend and Foe. Friend, you all are aware, and foe is a synonym used for enemy. Foe means someone who doesn't agree with us, someone who is not our friend. Okay, so fire, the chapter's title suggests that fire is both our friend and our enemy, our foe. Okay, so how is it related to social science, science, GK and literature? I will tell you. First of all, let's talk about science. Fire is a phenomena of science. It is a process that happens and we learn it in physics, chemistry, all the things of technology, not technology, but of science is related with fire. How? Fire takes place through a phenomena related to science, chemistry we can say. How fire exists when you put the stones together, the early humans did it, they got fire. And when you use some chemicals also, then also fire can come. Okay, so these are some things that is related to science and which here fire also is related to. How it is a social science phenomenon? Because when fire was not here, early human, they used to eat, you all know, raw materials and they were scared of the animals. All that things were there. So, with the invention of fire, man became a social animal. Early human became civilized. So it is a phenomenon of social science also, and science I have already told you, general knowledge also, because this is a general thing. We all must know that how fire came into existence, how fire is, what are the physical phenomena of fire, physical features of fire, chemical features of fire, everything we want we have to know. So general knowledge also is covered. Now coming to literature, all that theory of science, social science, all that is written in a form, and anything that we read, write, okay, or speak comes under the category of literature. So it is also covered. So Fire, Friend and Foe is the chapter that we are doing today, and it is a very interesting chapter, and fire is something that completes our life. We need food. Without fire we can't cook our food. We need shelter. With fire we burn some what can I say, wood and anything. We get the products ready because of the process in which fire is involved. Fire is used to protect us. So everywhere involvement of fire is there. So fire is a very essential thing. So we are going to study that how fire is our friend and foe. Fire is dangerous also. You have to be very cautious with fire. So it is an enemy also. So we are going to read in depth that how fire is our friend and how fire is our foe. So let's study together.
Okay, so let's now start the chapter. Let us read the story. Let us read the chapter Fire, Friend and Foe. fire is both useful and dangerous. What is fire? How did we discover it? How do we control it? So, first of all, a statement is there that fire is both useful and dangerous. So, it is very useful to us. It is very important part of our daily life. And at the same time, it is dangerous as well. So, how it is a friend? Because it is useful. How it is a foe? Foe, that is enemy. So, how it is a friend? Because it is useful. How it is our foe? Because it is dangerous. What is fire? So, the first question that we have to read in the chapter, that we have to understand in the chapter, is what fire really is. And second, how did we discover it? How we got to know about fire? How fire came into existence? Fire was already there, but how we discovered it? See, there are two things. One is invention and second is discovery. We are going to learn this, we are going to have a discussion about it soon. What is the difference between invention and a discovery? How do we control it? Fire, friend and foe. So how do we control it? First of all, we have to know what is fire. Second, we have to know how we got it. And third, how to control it. How do we control it? Being a friend, how it is useful to us, and being our foe, how to control the dangerous element that is present in fire. Fire, friend and foe. Early man didn't know what fire was. Okay, early human, the early man, they didn't know about what fire really was. But he must have seen the damage it could cause. So, fire was not known to early man. He didn't understand fire, but he had seen the fire. Okay, he had seen the harm that was created by fire, the disaster that was created by fire. How the fire creates disaster and how the fire creates disruption in life. The jungles, the forests, they all get what they are harmed by fire, and how human beings, they also get burned. So it is a very dangerous thing. So he must have seen all these elements of fire. So he was not aware that how fire came and how it was and what it was, but he was seeing that what is happening around him. The jungles are getting burned, the people are getting burned, the animals are getting burned. So all of that is true. He must have watched lightning and volcanoes. Okay, where do we see the element of fire? From volcanoes. In earlier time, when the man was not civilized, when the development was not there, when the people were not aware, there was a lot of volcanoes also. So from volcanoes, the eruption was there, volcanic eruption was there. So from it, early men got to know that what fire, how the fire causes disturbance. And lightning also, okay, lightning also he used to see. From the sky, the lightning comes and then the fire is created. So he was watching all of it very carefully. Fire was powerful. Something that is harming us is powerful, of course. Something that is weak is never dangerous, is never harmful. So something that is powerful can be harmful as well. Someone who is a weak person, how he will harm you? Only a strong man or woman can harm you. I'm not talking about physical, but both. Mentally, someone is strong, he can be harmful. Okay, he is powerful. But someone who is weak, how will he create any problem for you? And he was frightened. Okay, so early man was frightened by the fire, that how the fire is creating such havoc, how it was creating disaster, how everyone was getting harmed by it. So the man was naturally very frightened. Fire may have puzzled early men, but we now know that fire is the result of a chemical reaction. Okay, fire may have puzzled, means may have confused early men that what fire really was. So early man was confused about it, but we now know that fire is the result of a chemical reaction. As I have told you in the opening part of the video, in the introduction, that fire is related to science. Okay, here early man is being talked about, so social sciences here. And science, how? Because fire is created through a chemical process. Okay, so science is there. And when the oxygen, these lines are very important, mark them. When the oxygen in the air combines with carbon and hydrogen in a fuel, okay, what is the chemical reaction, what is the process? It is being told here that how fire gets created, that when oxygen gets, when the oxygen that is present in the air combines with the carbon and hydrogen in a fuel. You all know what is fuel, petroleum, all of that. In a fuel, a chemical reaction takes place. So when the oxygen that is present in the air gets combined with hydrogen and carbon, that is in a fuel, the carbon and hydrogen that is present in the fuel and the oxygen that is present in the air, when it gets combined, the fire is created through this chemical reaction. Energy in the form of heat and light is released in this process. So when it gets combined, an energy is released in the form of what? Heat and light. This is what we call fire. So this is what we actually call what fire is. When oxygen that is present in air getting combined with carbon and hydrogen that is present in fuel, and when as a reaction heat and light is being generated, this reaction is what fire is. So you have got what fire really is. Now three things that are needed to make fire are what? Fuel, first of all fuel, second oxygen, and third the heat. Wood, coal, cooking gas and petrol are some examples of fuel. So wood is there, coal is there, koila, and cooking gas is there. These are all some, and petrol also, these are the example of fuel. Okay, when three things that are required is fuel, that is wood, coal, cooking gas or petrol, etc. Or oxygen that is present in the air, and heat. These are required to create fire. These are required to make fire. When you blow, that is why when you blow on the smoldering paper, smoldering means that burns slowly without flame, burning slowly without flame. That is why when you blow on smoldering paper, it often bursts into flame. You must have seen smoldering paper. If you haven't, then then you can search it in the net. So the oxygen that is present in the air, fuel, you know the examples, coal, wood, everything, and heat is also there. So when you blow on the smoldering paper, when you blow air, so your oxygen, you are releasing the oxygen, and the smoldering paper, it is it has that chemical of the fuel, so it burns. The third thing needed to make fire is heat. Fuel and oxygen do not make fire by themselves. Okay, oxygen is present in air, fuel is, I have told you the examples, and third thing is heat, and only oxygen and fuel will not make the fire, but we require heat also. Or else a newspaper or a stick lying in the open could catch fire on its own. So newspaper, it also has petrol, okay, it is a fact. So when newspaper will be lying on what, on a surface, air will be there, oxygen is present, So naturally it could get burnt. So that is not there because it requires heat also. That is why they don't get burnt on their own. To burn a piece of paper or wood, what we require, we heat it before it catches fire. So we heat it, okay? To burn the paper, we use matchsticks. We generally do it with a lighted match, okay? Lighted match means that matchstick only, or we use it to burn the paper, okay? Every fuel has a particular temperature at which it begins to burn. So every fuel is having a different temperature of its own that at which it begins to burn. This temperature is called the flash point or kindling temperature of the fuel. So this is also very important. Mark it down. Every fuel is having a particular temperature of its own, which is called the flash point or the kindling temperature of the fuel. It is sometimes said that fire is a good servant but a bad master. Okay, it is said that fire is a good servant but a bad master. So what is the quality of a servant? Servant follows. Okay, servant follows his master every time. So fire is a good servant because it follows us. If we use fire very carefully, if we command fire very carefully, then it is a very good servant. But it is a bad master. How? When fire is generated on its own, when fire has no control by anyone, then it is very bad. Okay? It only means that fire is very useful as long as it is kept under a control. So very important thing, got it? That a servant is controlled by its master, so he is very nice. So is fire when it is under control. But when the servant is the master, when he becomes the master, he will be ruthless. He will not have any restrictions over him. Okay. So that is why fire is a good servant but a bad master. Okay. For instance, we used to cook our food. Okay. For example, we used to cook our food, warm our homes in winter and to generate electricity. Okay, so these are some important things that are there, that how fire is a good servant. For example, we used to cook our food, okay, warm our homes in winter and to generate electricity, we use fire. But on the other hand, if fire gets out of control, it can be very dangerous. Suppose we are cooking our food, but we are careless. We don't see the flame and all. What will happen? Or we have left the gas on, and the gas is on, and we put the matchstick, the cylinder can blast. Okay, so that is very important thing, that fire is, for cooking it is fine, but we have to control it. We don't have to let fire control us, but we have to control the fire. It can be very dangerous. Okay, each year thousands of homes and shops are damaged by fire. So every year many of the homes are getting burned, short circuit is there. Okay, everything is there like that because of fire. That is why it is said that we don't keep the coals that we use in winter to warm ourselves inside our home, so that what happens, it can burn our house, and what else, we can get choked also. Vast areas of forest are also destroyed and hundreds of people are killed or injured. So vast means wide area of forest also get destroyed because of fire, and hundreds of people are being killed or injured. So people are getting killed because of fire and people are getting injured because of fire. So it is a very bad thing about fire. Just as three things are needed to start a fire, there are three main ways in which a fire can be put out. So three things that we have discussed: oxygen, fuel and heat. Like, similar, Similarly, we have three ways to putting out the fire. Put out means to switch off the fire. We will not switch off like a button, but to put off, to put it out, to blow it off. We have three ways to do so. Okay. So this is there, and these three things we are going to read in the next part of our chapter. The video will be shared next time. So we will see that one of the three things needed for burning is taken away. In each way, what happens? We take away one of the things that is required to burn. Okay, fuel, fire, fuel, oxygen, and heat. So these ways we are going to understand in the next part of the chapter. And for today, this much is there. And we have seen how fire is generated and how fire is very useful, how fire is very harmful. And we are going to understand few more things about fire when we will meet again next time.
Okay, so here the part one of our chapter concludes. And I hope that you have understood it. We have seen how fire is very useful, how fire came to existence, and all of the things we studied in our chapter. In the next video, we are going to conclude our chapter, because it is not in the form of a story, but we are going to conclude it. So till that time, complete the work that I am assigning to you and complete all the work and watch the next video also to understand the chapter in depth. So I am Aman from DPS Sadwani Ramachaur. You are watching PTO classes. Thank you so much for watching the